Hi everyone, in today's video we're going to have another modelling challenge. So the one that I've found today is this one. So again, taken from GrabCAD. I'm not entirely sure what it is from. Obviously it's like a Canon of some kind, but look like quite a cool little thing to have, try and model, a couple of different parts to it. So let's jump into it. Now I am only working on one screen today, so I'm going to sort of jump and bring that up a couple of times. So first thing I'm looking at doing is, like, first thoughts again, I haven't seen this before, like I haven't modelled this before, I'm kind of just talking, I'll work it out as we're going through it, is this part here is going to be a revolve. Annoyingly the image is a little bit blurry, so some measurements might be a little bit difficult to see, but what I'm thinking is, we'll revolve this one, so draw half the profile, revolve it round, wheel should be pretty simple, and then the rest will just be like simple extrude. So let's start with this part here first. So what we want to do, I reckon, is, okay, we've got an overall measurement there of 136. Let's do that first. I'm going to do start, and let's do here, and we'll do a line here. In the middle, I'll do 136. Hit enter. So we'll do that as our center line. All right, so what have we got going on here? So we have got, let's start on this end over here. So the first one we've got is, okay, we don't have a measurement for the height of there that I can see. So we know what that is. So now that's 8. Okay, right, let's change the plan. Let's start from this side and work our way down. So we are going to have a radius of 8 there. So let's do a radius of 12 there. So let's do circle D. Radius, that should be 8. Okay, we're done, it's started. No going back now. And then, okay, we're going to have a line, I'm going to do a construction line here. Do to there, let's do 11 just as a construction line. I'm just thinking for this part here. And that radius 12, so we'll call it 6. So let's do up, call that 6. Now I don't want that to be construction line, so let's turn construction off. Then alpha line like that. Yeah, not construction line. There we go. Okay. I'm gonna trim that bit off. Then actually let's extend that, trim that off as well. Okay, I don't want the foot line. Okay. Next we have got, okay, that is there is 28.5. There to there is 15. Okay, so there does seem to be quite a few measurements missing from this, annoyingly. Oh no, actually, I suppose it, that's going to be 20? Yeah. So, okay, right. And that's going to be 14 there. So let's do line. And do 7. Enter, okay. So that up there and then come across. That's going to be 20, so that will be 10. Do 10. Okay. Next, we've got the distance between that, which should be 15. So let's do that. Let's do dimension, that's there. 50. Okay. Connect. There we go. That needs to be. Include that stability, but we don't have any rounded. Okay, so I said 2.5 there. That's a radius of 25, so let's do. Line up 3.5 divided by 2. And then that needs to be 5 mil thick. 5 and down. Okay. And then fillets, we've got is 2.5. That's 2 fillet. 2.5. Okay. I am just going to give this a save. I'm not sure what modeling challenge we're up to. Let's say 5, I might be wrong, but I've got it saved at least. Alright. Done here, and then that is to 20, and that's another 20. Got 20. Right, there should also be 20. 10 rather, because it is the same as it off, which is what we want. Then we got another one of those. So that was 25. So let's come up. So let's do another 5. Was that 25? Yeah. And put it under 2.5. Okay, I've got this measurement wrong here, haven't I? Clearly, that's. That bit. Okay, so oh, 25 divided by 2. That's what it was. Okay, enter line down. Then let's do fillet 2.5. So grab and grab 2.5. I thought my voice is very echoey in this room, but hopefully it's not coming across too bad on my mic. Okay, hopefully you can start to see the profile we've got coming along and where we're up to. So we're along to here. But again, here we've got 8, and that is 10 and 8. So again, we're in line with that. So that should be 8. Just dimension that just to make sure. All good. Okay, look here. Any dimension? You got a dimension? You do. Again, 25. So line. Okay. That looks like that's gonna have chamfer on it, but we'll have a look at that in a little bit. That is 20, so let's do 9 of 20. Okay, am I starting line with something else? Okay, is that in line with that maybe? That's a very inaccurate way of measuring things. That's in line with that. As you can see from my very steady cursor, but it's not moving at all, I think that and that are in line. So that was the diameter of 14, so radius of 7. So let's do... got about 20. Right, let's do construction line. And I've forgotten what that measurement needs to be. 50. D. 50. There we go. And then we are doing 14. A 7. So, I'll take construction off. Come up 7. Then let's connect like that. Let's just turn that up a second so you can see the profile we've got going on. Let's put this back on. Okay, and then okay, I didn't want to do that yet, so let's trim that. Don't know if you can hear that, but it sounds biblical storms going on outside. So we'll do 5. And I'm going to do fillet of, let's say, 4 round fillet, I'm assuming. Okay, so that is fine, so it has to be 2.5 then, doesn't it? So if we do fillet. Okay, and then what I can do is line and find the edge of that fillet, which is there. Okay, so I think that's the end of that. Let's finish sketch. Let's go to Evolve. Let's grab all the profiles. Access, let's grab this one. And there we've got like our main canon thing. All right, a few things to do to that. Clearly we have got a chamfer on that edge. But it doesn't tell us what that is, but we'll just add one anyway. Okay, and then we've got a whole 8mm hole going. Yeah, so let's do sketch. Circle 8 P, that should be minus 50. There we go. Let's do modify and chamfer. Now there isn't an actual measurement for that chamfer annoyingly, so let's just drag it in a little bit. Something like that. If you managed to find out what that chamfer was, please let me know. And then we've got circle No, I've never burned a hole going through. Okay, this bit. So let's do construct tangent plane. In the middle, so that's P of object. Bit of construction line in there, there we go. And that's turn construction off, and that should be a 9.5 circle, 9.5 into extrude. Let's drag that out. Okay, so looks to me like we have got that part. Wrong thing. Finished. But maybe I've extruded this hole too far. Okay, I think that extrude should be 45. That's not that one. Let's edit and do that. Okay, that looks more like it. Okay, so part one done. Let's do the side profiles here. Obviously, you can just do one and copy and paste it. So let's now create a sketch. In fact, let's do a bit of tangent construction plane first of all. I'm trying to drag it out there first, just so I can draw it in place. Do that. I'm going to turn this body off in a second. So we want to do it that way around. So let's start with line, turn you off, and I'm just going to rough out the shape a little bit first. Not too worried about that at the minute. Now let's do some dimensions. So first of all, that should be 50 dimension. 50. Next, that should be 20. This one here should also be 20. Okay, what's this bottom one? That's a 20. By 10. Length there, 55. Length there, 20. Here. That's what we got. That's across. Okay, so that should be 20. That should be 20. And then is there R30? So let's go create arc. That's there. Command D. R30. Oh, failed to solve. Y. What have I missed so far? everything off. I haven't done that one yet. That needs to be 10 as well. Okay, sometimes we have to give in, do the lines a little bit of a shake so you can see what's constrained and what's not. Okay, that isn't. So the only one that looks wrong then is this arc here. So that should be 35, but I don't think it's going to be. Oh no, there we go. So that piece is done. So let's finish that. Keep pressing the wrong thing. We want that to be 5mm thick, so let's do E for extrude, 5mm. I'll probably turn off. Okay. Right, I've got a few little details that need to be cut into that. Right, so what we've got is some circles. So circles in the centre of those squares. That radius and everything is 4 as well, so remember that. So, create a sketch. So, if we construction line and say that's a square. Then we do that. Find a circle. That needs to be 10.5. So let's do a 10.5. Okay. Let's do another one. You need to be equal to you. You need to be in line with you. That's there we go. Okay, so that is locked in place. Then we have another circle that is, oh, I can't make that out. 6.45. Do 6.45, yeah, 6.45. Okay, let's do circle, 6.45. Let's do horizontal vertical, you be in line with you. When we dimension, you and you need to be how far away? 30. We should try to get a non pixelated thing possible. And then I've got one more hole. That is 25mm away from there, but does it give me any more information on that? Do I assume that's in the middle? Doesn't look. Does it look in the middle? I'm not finding any other measurement that it isn't in the middle. Okay, let's do line there. Let's do center line 25. counter and circle. Construction off, and that should be 5. Okay. Finish sketch. Need to extrude. Grab the profiles. Round and cut. Okay, so we've got those parts there. We've got some fillets that need doing, which I think we said last sort of like earlier. 4 fillets and 2 there. Okay. So these ones are all 4. The top two. Was that one for me? That's a 2. One more fillet. Or 2. Okay. So we will need 2 of these. Try and roughly figure out whereabouts it's going. So if I take this one, move, copy, that sort of. For now, just roughly put it into place. Control C, B. Okay, so starting to get our cannon thing. Right. Let's do. Which one's which? Okay, so that's going to have a circle grab through the EH54. Time for 5. Okay. And that needs to be 54. We're doing more body. Because then got a chamfer of. That's 45 degrees. Okay, let's take this body. Take this body. Okay, and then let's take that body a little bit more centrally. Okay, I'm getting there. Next. That I'm going to assume it's for the wheels, and that I'm going to assume is for the actual bit in the middle. That's a total of 56. Okay, so let's do a sketch circle in the middle. Already forgotten. 8.5. That I must have done. Okay, so that is gonna be thicker on the inside than it is on the outside, obviously. Let's do E minus four. Doing your body. And now let's turn up you. Okay. Then we're gonna have new circle. And that's gonna be 6.35. Start. Circle. 3.65. Need to extrude. That needs to be 5. No, 5. You can join as a chamfer. The same on the other side, so that I could do that, or let's do the plane new, new, create mirror features, there we go, turn that off, right, let's turn the mod podge back on. And copy. Okay, something isn't quite. Let's copy. There. Might be the part for the wheels, maybe. Well, we'll leave that for now. Okay. Just because that looks a little bit weird. Next. Let's do this part, so we are doing twelve, 18 wide. Let's do that. Let's do this. Construct plane. There we go. Then we're guaranteed to be in the middle. Create a sketch. Active circle. I'm not doing 12 mil. I should project that actually. Circle. 12 mil. In protrude. Nope. In protrude. Symmetric. -18 -18 -18 One second. -6. Okay, I've clearly got somewhere on these holes appear wrong. Oh, I've got the distance right, that's good. Anybody? Let's go and create a sketch. And that should have a circle of 10. E. Bring it down. -5. We're going to do another one of 7.9. Then that comes down. 13. Okay, which means that extruded wrong. There we go, that looks more like it. Oh, actually, no, okay. That is looking much more like what it should look like, I feel. Put 2.5 chamfer in there, modify chamfer 2.5. Okay, and then that is, what's that? 2.4 mm hole right at the edge. do this to make a midline. So that's with 80, so let's go. Minus party. Okay. And use that to split body. Okay. You don't want anymore. You I do want. Modify. Create. Mirror. Bodies. You. There. Let's then take you, your copy. There we go, that's starting to look a lot more. Where's my sticker feel? Leave visibility to turn that off. Move and copy. There you go, yeah, this is looking. There you go, that'll be a lesson in patience for you. Assuming things are wrong because it looks weird when you're not even finished yet. But the only thing I'm really not totally sure of is the thickness of that bit, but we'll have a look at that in a minute. So I need to have another one of these. So let's do draw V. Bring that over. Okay, and then all that's left to do is to do our wheels. So let's have a look. So we're going to have an overall radius of 49. So let's do a circle here, circle 49. Okay, and then another circle of 36. Let's extrude that first of all. That should be 9 mil. New body. Oh, I've not selected the whole profile. Okay, and another circle, and that is 36. Circle 36. And that comes in 2 mils, that's extrude. Minus 2. Then there's a chamfer on there, isn't there? That modify chamfer. Okay. And then what we've got is let's go to radius 12, so I can do a circle on here, circle radius 12. Radius, not diameter. That should be 34. There we go, that's better. And then we're going to do 4 circles, diameter of 7. So let's go circle 7. We won't be able to, it'll be 7 over 2. Will we seven? Okay, some of these dimensions do not seem quite right, so I'll have to change a few things. Okay, let's do horizontal vertical. That. Let's do pattern, set the pattern. E to extrude, grab those four profiles. Okay, so that is our wheels done. So the only thing I changed there was the radius of the distance of the circles, because actually I don't think that is right. So if the radius of that is 24. Ugh, idiot. Let's go back. There we go. Oh, okay, right, I've not changed anything. Always check you're looking at radius versus diameter. All right. Let's just take U and I'll see Control V, drag you across to here. Let's mirror these two across. So, Origin, are you right in the middle? Hopefully. No. Okay, let's turn it off. Let's do a midplane, construct, midplane. Like that. Then let's do create, mirror, grab, grab. Like that. Let's turn this off. Let's have a look what we've got. If anything, let's just take this body, move copy. The pivot point to there. No, that's there. Like that. So the only thing that I am not dead set on is this seems a little bit off. That should be 6.3, but I'm pretty sure which sketch would that be? Oh, and there you go, fixed it. Okay. Perfect. So actually, I think we've got it all there. So yeah, the only thing I was not certain of was that clearly I'd put in the wrong diameter. So modelling side of things done. I think that's quite cool. I will add a couple of materials. Let me just give it a quick little save. I'm not quite sure how long this one's been going on for. I think it's probably going to be a little bit longer. modeling challenge. So let's have a look. So probably let's get some materials on there. Let's go for some metal. Get some sort of steel. Maybe not as girl. Paint. Metallic. Something like that. Oh, one thing. Really got anything in mind, I'll just sort of drag it on to make it look a little bit less boring. Check the colour of the wheels, I think. What should we do? See, so we spent longer messing around with colours than you do actually modelling it. Oh, one thing. Nah, not like that one. Okay, let's leave that there, although I spent forever trying to play around with the materials. Let's see, let's grab like a I almost want to add like wooden wheels. I don't like that. Okay, no, I am really gonna leave it there. Okay, right, let's just see. Let's put background on there, let's put reflections on there, turn that roughness up a little bit. I'll just mess with the focal thing annoyingly. Okay, so what lines do I put on? Okay, so we'll leave that there. I'll leave that to render. I've not really got any plan when I was putting the materials on there. But quite a fun little modelling challenge, a few different little parts to look at. There was a couple we weren't entirely sure of what we got there in the end. I will make sure I put that link in the description as well. Hopefully you found that useful and interesting. Got any questions? Please leave a comment down below or email me at designwithsimon@outlook.com.